And what a Friday for baseball. Welcome to Stillwell Stadium, where today the Kennesaw State Owls play host to the Fairfield Stags for the first time ever in a three-game series. Nolan Alexander with you today, joined by former Kennesaw State coach and now turned pro broadcaster Trey Fowler. Trey, you were on the call just a couple of days ago when Kennesaw State made it six straight over Georgia State. What are your thoughts on that win for the Owls?
I think that was a big win for the Owls. Anytime you win an in-state rivalry game, it's big for recruiting. It's big for the team. That was a nice come-from-behind victory just like they had last Friday night. The team's continuing to show fight. That's a good indicator early in the season.
Today, the opponent, the Fairfield Stags, a team that last year caught the nation's attention, was ranked by Baseball America for the first time ever, started out 28-0, finished the season winning the MAC's first at-large berth to the Big Dance, was a finalist in the Austin Regional before the Longhorns, of course, went on to Omaha. This year for Fairfield, their strength returns in pitching, Trey.
Absolutely. We'll see one of those pitchers on the mound today, Michael Sansone, a Cape All-Star in 2021. The Owls offense will have their hands full with him, but they do return a lot of guys on the mound, and it starts right there with Sansone.
On the mound today for Kennesaw State, it's Jack Myers, the Butler transfer, makes his second start for the season. Four innings, three hits, three earned, one walk, and seven strikeouts against Morehead State. Last week, he did not pick up the win or the loss in that game for Kennesaw State. Sits with a 6.75 ERA through one start. Kennesaw State today, we'll get to the starting lineups in just a moment with the black hats, the gold KS Interlocked logo on top of the black caps, the white pinstripe jerseys today with Owls in front in black trimmed in gold. Same for the numbers in the back. Fairfield visiting out of Fairfield, Connecticut, again out of the MAC Conference, making its first trip here to the Shake. With red hats today, the Fairfield logo slanted in black on the front of the brim with a white undertone. Gray tops with red writing across the front, trimmed in white. Same for the numerals on the back. Red piping down the sides, gray pants with a red stripe down each of the sides. Here for the Stags, coming in at 2-1 of the season. They took 2 out of 3 against Elon, picked preseason number 4 in the Colonial Athletic Conference. And this marks the fourth of a 20-game road trip to open up the season. Kennesaw State sitting at 4-1 in the year, took 3 out of 4 against Morehead State last weekend, and then won the midweek game against Georgia State. So here we go. Colin Kelly, the shortstop up, takes the first pitch from Myers, sends it deep down the left field side, running over near foul ground is Zach Corbin, and he drops it. Picks it up in foul territory, his throw comes into the outfield, and Kelly is aboard at the midway station on the first pitch of the ballgame, Trey.
That was a tough play there for Corbin, one of those plays going to the left field line. The wind played a little effect on that. It's blowing it back towards the field and just overran it just a little bit, couldn't corral it.
So a tough play there for Corbin. Not a cloud in the sky today. Wind blowing from left to right. 61 degrees at first pitch. Myers into the stretch, and this one is ripped through the right side. Bichetti with a base knock. Kelly held up at third base. The throw coming in from Kalina in right is cut off in the infield, and the Stags have runners on the corners here to start the ballgame.
Stags coming out aggressive. They probably saw the video from a week ago. Myers is going to attack the strike zone. They do not want him to get to that changeup, which is his out pitch.
So Colin Kelly aboard with an E7. Mike Bichetti, the second baseman, on with a single through the right side. And Charlie Pagliarini, the third baseman up here, they go left, right, left throughout the lineup. Righty on lefty matchup. The pitch from Myers is in there for a strike, 0-1. Scoreless here in the top of the first. Fairfield threatening on the corners with no outs.
If you're Myers here, you're just looking to limit the damage, keep it minimum, give your offense a chance.
Open stance from the left side. Myers along looking with Hassan. Here's the pitch. Swing and a fly ball to right field. Kalina drifting back, trying to block the sunlight with his tan glove. Camps out underneath, has a one-handed squeeze. His throw comes towards second base. There's no throw home. And a sacrifice fly scores Colin Kelly from third, and Fairfield goes on top 1-0 here in the first.
It's that time of day where that sun is brutal on the right fielder, the first baseman. Kalina, being a veteran of Kennesaw State, played that one well, used the glove to shade the sun from his eyes, makes a nice catch there and gets it in to keep Bichetti at first base.
And here's Mike Caruso, righty up, batting 300 on the season for the cleanup spot. To start behind the plate today for Fairfield. One on, one out, 1-0 Stags. Righty on righty as Myers nods with Hassan. Now to the plate. Swing and a hot shot past Simon at short as it dances into left field. Another line drive hit for the Stags. And Fairfield has now three times swung and connect baseline by Cash Young, the third baseman in the infield grass. And the hit parade continues for Fairfield. That's the third single of the inning here for the Stags.
That one right there, first pitch changeup. Good job by Kalina to keep that ball in front of him. Had a chance at second base if the throw was on target, just a little offline.
Boy, Myers would kill for a double play right here. Bases loaded with one out, 1-0 Fairfield in the top of the first. And here's the six hole, Mike Zaffino. A righty on righty matchup. Here's the offering, and that fastball is at the letters, 1-0. Defensively for Kennesaw State, Edson, at first base. Hudson Mims gets the start at second today. Tyler Simon, the captain of the infield, at short. Cash Young at third. Nick Hassan, the battery made of Myers. 1-0. Swing and a miss. Just underneath the hands, 1-1. Zach Corbin in left. Josh Hatcher, man center field. Nick Kalina in right. Myers taps the front left foot, kicks and fires a big bending breaking ball that hangs high, 2-1.
You mentioned it before, Nolan, he'd love a ground ball here. You get the double play, you keep it at one, you feel pretty good about ending this first inning.
Zaffino up here, the team's leader in RBIs with four. The pitch, a breaking ball grounded to short. Simon Fields flips onto Mims, the relay to first, it is in time! Jack Myers gets a visit from his best friend. The 6-4-3 double play gets him out of a jam, but Fairfield strikes first with one run off of three base hits. There's an error, and the Stags strand two. We head on to the home half of the first inning with the score. Fairfield 1 and Kennesaw State nothing on the KSU OWL Network. Welcome you back to Stillwell Stadium in Kennesaw, where Fairfield goes on top. And the lid lifter of this three-game set, 1-0 over Kennesaw State, thanks to a sacrifice fly by Charlie Pagliarini. Nolan Alexander with Trey Fowler. Let's take a look at the starting lineup for Kennesaw State today. Leading it off, playing center field, it's Josh Hatcher. Batting second at third base, Cash Young. Hitting third in left field, Zach Corbin. Batting fourth and catching, Nick Hassan. Hitting fifth and playing first base, Braden Edson. Yeah, we'll touch on that Edson story here later. Batting sixth, the shortstop, Tyler Simon. Hitting seventh in right field, Nick Colina. Batting eighth, the DH, Donovan Cash. And hitting ninth, the second baseman, Hudson Mims. And we saw Myers on the hill in the top of the first. Michael Sansone, a southpaw, on the bump for the Stags. Here against the lefty, Josh Hatcher. Reach base and four straight for KSU. With a sign from Caruso, hands over his head, wind and the pitch. And that's popped up foul and hits the top of the net. 0-1.
Key for the Owls offense today versus Sansone. They've got to be able to hit the fastball inside. He likes to work into both lefties and righties. Their success will be predicated on how well they handle that pitch.
The 0-1. Swing and a pop-up in the outfield grass. The shortstop Kelly drifting back, trying to fight the sunlight, and he does as he reaches above the red cap and squeezes the first out. One away.
You'll see the fastball range from 85 to 87 for Sansone. Mostly fastball, slider to the left-handed hitters, fastball changeup to the right-handed hitters. Changeup is a really, really good swing and miss pitch.
Cash Young, the third baseman, strolls up to the right side. Owls down 1-0 here in the first. Wind up in the offering. A fastball right down Frey Road, 0-1. Young rides a three-game hitting streak into the ball game today. Hitting .222 on the year, 4-for-18. A couple of home runs, he's driven in 9. Paces the Owls in that category. 0-1 on the way. Check swing on a pitch that grabs the outside corner around the knees. 0-2 quickly on Young. Sansone 1-0, winning opening day against Elon with a 3.60 ERA. 5 innings, 2 hits, 2 earned, 8 strikeouts, and just 1 walk. Nods and the 0-2 pitch. That's high at the letters. 1-2.
Good job here early to Cash Young. Mixing pitches, back-to-back changeups to start, elevated fastball there. Let's see if he goes back to the changeup, 1-2.
Lefty nods, and he fires. Swing and a pop-up sent over to first, and it's squeezed just inside. A fair foul line by Berg Evan. Two away and a couple of pop-ups.
He did go back to the changeup there. Got an awkward swing out of Cash Young. Good job by Sansone with that one.
So base is empty. Two up, two down for Kennesaw State. Down 1-0. Home half of the first. Zach Corbin up to the right side. Sansone stares down and then time call to the plate. Corbin hitting .400 this year, 6-for-15. A triple and 2 driven in. Sansone with the nod. Hands over the head, wind in the pitch. And the fastball connects at the knees for a strike, 0-1.
Right side of the plate is the natural side of the plate for Corbin. A little bit more power from the right side.
Lone switch hitter in the lineup today for KSU. Awaits the 0-1, here it is. And that misses outside. Sansone on the bump, 5'8", 170 out of Cheshire, Connecticut. Notre Dame West Haven product. Black glove just underneath the brim of his cap, stares down, winds and deals, swing and a miss. Corbin over the top as that one ran in the basement. Count moves to 1-2. Kick the pitch, swinging a pop-up that's beyond Stillwell Stadium over us here in the press box. Shadows from the press box slowly creeping up behind short amount of foul ground, separating Caruso the backstop. And today's home plate umpire Kevin Elzey, just to the first row of bleachers. 1-2 the count on Corbin, and the pitch. That misses high above the hands, 2-2. Mentioned a sunny day here at the Shake, 61 degrees, wind blowing now in from left field. Fairfield in the first base dugout leaning over the railing. Owls up the third base side in the shade. The 2-2 pitch. Swing, another pop-up. Behind the dish, Caruso sheds the mask, runs over to the on-deck circle in front of the Stags dugout and puts it away. So a trio of pop-ups for Sansone in the first inning. Nothing across for the Owls. We head to the second inning. The score, Fairfield 1, Kennesaw State nothing on the KSU Owl Network. Top of the second inning here from Stillwell Stadium, 1-0 Fairfield over KSU. Our score, Nolan Alexander joined by Trey Fowler. Jack Myers in the bump for his second inning of action. Up to his hips and base knocks in the first inning, but got a 6-4-3 double play to get out of a bases-loaded jam. And Fairfield swinging on the first pitch yet again. Ryan Strollo, the center fielder, up from the left side and dribbles it foul to the far edge of the first base dugout, 0-1.
Fairfield hitters have obviously been very aggressive here early.
0-1. And that dots the outside corner about knee-high, 0-2.
If Jack can get the secondary pitches down in the zone, he can use some of that aggressiveness to his advantage.
The righty's 0-2 pitch. Swing and a ground ball out to second base. Hudson Mims knocks it down on a high hop, slings to first, not in time. It was a low roller, and then on the last hop, snuck up and stuck him on the left hip. Came down to the dirt. He was quick to retrieve it, make the flip to first, but Strollo beats it out.
First baseman number 24, Matt Bergevin.
So again, the leadoff man aboard for Fairfield here in the second inning, Matt Bergevin, the first baseman, stands in from the right side. Goes down as an E4, so second error for the Owls in as many innings. The pitch to Bergevin grabs the inside corner, 0-1.
Nice breaking ball there to get ahead in the count.
Myers peeks back over the left shoulder. Edson holds the runner on. 0-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Waved on a higher offering, 0-2. Bergevin hitting .417. He's 5-for-12 on the year with a couple driven in. .583 slugger, hitting .571 when runners are aboard. 1-0 Fairfield here in the top of the second. One on, no outs. Myers ready. The Butler transfer fires a breaking ball that dives off the plate, 1-2.
Strollo has the Stags' only stolen base so far on the year. Myers will have to keep him close over there.
Hudson Mims at second base, playing closer to the back than Simon in the hole at short. The 1-2. A breaking ball that looked good on the inner half. 2-2. Again, Kevin Elzey behind home plate. Three-man officiating crew today. Patrick Gentu, the umpire, up the first base side. Aaron Shorch up the third baseline. Two-two. Swing and a ground ball, hit foul. The Stags' third base coach's box. Count remains the same here in the eight-hole hitter. Evan Berta up from the left side, takes a couple of practice cuts on deck up the first baseline. Myers, a look back over at first. Edson continues to hold the runner on. Another 2-2. Swing and a foul off of the plate. Myers in the stretch. Long stare down, another 2-2 as the runner goes. It's popped up. Shallow right field. Edson, the first baseman, foul ground, circling, and cannot make an over-the-shoulder basket grab as it spits out of the leather.
That was a tough one right there for Braden. He had the sun to play with, the wind to play with, and that little bit of dip down the hill there at first base had him turning around. Tough play.
So a long 2-2 count continues against the 8-hole hitter, Matt Bergevin, the first baseman, and Jack Myers. And the righty's delivery. Swing and a ground ball to the hole. It's short underneath the diving Tyler Simon to his right. It sprinkles into the glove of Zach Corbin in left field, and Fairfield has its fourth hit of the day. All have been singles. So, Trey, we knew the scouting report on Fairfield coming in. This is a team that lost some of its offensive firepower from last year as its top hitter out for the game today. But you knew this is a team that went to a regional final last year. There's something about them. They're one of those gritty Northeast teams. Tough to get an out no matter who's up there at the dish. Berta shows bunt, dribbled to the left side of the mound, underneath the glove of Myers. Picked up in the middle infield, another base knock for the Stags.
It's just a well-placed bunt there by Berta. Ball that Cash Young could have tried to come over and make the play on, but you just got to tip your cap there to Berta. He put it in a perfect spot just out of the reach of Myers. Nothing the Owls can do, and now the Stags have the bases loaded. To go back to your point, Nolan, this is a team that's riding the momentum from a year ago. Really doesn't matter once you start winning which guys fill the uniforms. That winning tradition, that winning culture carries on. It's something that Coach Coe talked about on our call yesterday, that they just seem to find a way, no matter who's wearing the Fairfield uniform, they find a way to do things the right way and win ball games. And they're showing us here why so far in the early going of this one.
Pass the pitching coach out to huddle up with the Owls. Calm down, Myers here. He was in a similar situation last inning. Had the bases loaded with one out. Induced a 6-4-3 twin killer to close down the first inning against six-hole hitter Matt Zaffino. But now it's Colin Kelly. He reached on an error in left to start the ballgame.
Colin Kelly taking over in that leadoff spot.
Righty on lefty, stands tall from the left side. The pitch from Myers, swing and a miss. 0-1.
That leadoff spot that began the year is Mike Handel's spot, their top returning hitter, got injured last week. On behalf of Kennesaw State Athletics and the baseball program, want to extend our thoughts and prayers to him for a speedy recovery.
Mm-hmm. 0-1. Off the plate, a ball and a strike. Kelly here, batting 286 on the year. Includes the last at bat. 250 with runners on, 333 in scoring position. One RBI in the season. Three extra base hits, all have been two baggers. 1-1 from Myers. Swing and a line drive, sent into right field directly at Kalina. He makes the catch. Runner tags from third as the throw comes in towards the mound. Another sacrifice fly for Fairfield, and the Stags go on top 2-0 here in the second.
Great job by Kelly getting a ball a little bit up that he could get to the outfield. That's what you're looking to do in that situation. Good job by Kalina to play that line drive well. Caught it a little flat-footed, didn't allow him to get as much on the throw to have a chance at the plate there.
Mike Bichetti singled in the first. Righty up here, runners in first and second, one out now. The pitch from Myers is letter high, 1-0.
Bichetti played in 42 of 43 games for the Stags in 2021.
1-0 pitch. Swinging a chopper, third base side. That's foul. 1-1. Yep, last season, 34 hits, 26 ribbies. Playing a little DH and second baseman.
He had no errors last year and 79 chances on the infield. That's pretty impressive.
Sticks on the board here. The 1-1. Breaking ball outside. Hassan looks over at first, does not throw. Two balls and a strike. Baseball's a funny game, Trey. Bichetti, no errors. And almost 80 chances, and Kennesaw State with a couple errors here. Through four outs. 2-1. Swing and a miss. Sawed him off at the hands. 2-2.
Couple of uncharacteristic errors at that. Zach Corbin, very good defender no matter where you put him. Tough play on the line. Hudson Mims is out there for his defense and his grit. Ball just hopped up on him. Couple tough breaks here early in the game.
2-2 the count. 2-0 Fairfield in the second. 2 aboard. The righty fires. Swinging a ground ball back up the middle. Out of the reach of Hudson Mims. It's in center field. Runner waved around third. And Hatcher's throw comes to short. An RBI base knock for Mike Bichetti. 3-0 Fairfield.
Just a great job of putting the ball in play. You put it in play, it finds holes. They've done that a few times here, just not refusing to strike out with two strikes, putting balls in play. They had one just out of the reach of Simon, just out of the reach of Mims there. They're still set up nice, first and second with one out.
Berg Avenue comes home to score. Berta at second base, Bichetti at first. Pagliarini. The sack fly up from the left side. The pitch. Good at the knees on the inner half, 0-1.
Pagliarini's got some power, all-time home run leader at his high school, St. Joseph's in Connecticut. So he's got some power. We know how the ball travels here to right field. Left-handed hitters love hitting in Stillwell Stadium.
Slow start this year, 1-for-13, though. Looking for his first base knock RBI. And this pitch is grounded hard to second base. Scooped off the ground by Mims. Flips to the right hand to Simon. The relay to first. Another double play for Kennesaw State. 4-6-3. So back-to-back innings that Jack Myers benefits from a double play in the middle infield. However, Fairfield comes across with a couple of more runs on the board. We go bottom two with the shake with a score. Fairfield 3 and Kennesaw State nothing here on the KSU Owl Network.
Spring freezing.
Bottom two at Stillwell Stadium in the series opener between Fairfield and Kennesaw State. Nolan Alexander with Trey Fowler. 3-0 Fairfield. Line score so far, 3 runs on 6 hits. All singles for the Stags. No errors, 3 stranded. No runs, no hits, a couple errors. And none left on for Kennesaw State. Sansone in the home half of the first had 3 pop-ups. Here's Nick Hassan from the cleanup spot. Lefty on righty matchup. Wide the pitch from Sansone, swing and a miss. Hassan mistimes that one 0-1.
Sansone using the changeup a lot here to these right-handed hitters, especially early in the count.
Hassan a 308 batter, riding a 5-game hitting streak. 0-1. Swing and a miss. Over the top there, 0-2.
Back-to-back changeups to Hassan, just like he did to Cash Young, and Cash is at bat in the first inning.
Hassan 4 for 13 on the year with a couple driven in. Down 0-2 here to the lefty. Wind and the pitch. Called strike 3. A fastball that pushes through the back door, freezes Hassan in the lower half of the zone, and there's one away.
Good job of hitting a spot there by Sansone. The catcher set up a little bit off the plate, and Kevin Elsie, the home plate umpire, gave it to him.
And here's Braden Edson, the first baseman, up from the left side. 3-0, KSU trails in the second. The pitch from Sansone. Swinging a foul off there at the dish, 0-1. Edson batting a .188 on the year. 3 for 16 with 3 driven in.
He's a player coach co-identified as one of those guys, kind of like Hassan was a year ago, hitting one of the toughest 188s on the team. A lot of high exit speeds on that 188.
0-1 pitch. Watches one up and away, a ball and a strike. And Trey, what's that like as a player? Because in some ways that gives you confidence. On the other side, I'm sure that's very frustrating as well.
We really want the guys to be process-driven.
1-1 pitch. A strike at the knees, 1-2.
And when they are process-driven, they don't let the results eat them up. If they're a result-driven guy, that can be very frustrating. They can start looking to try and change things, which is the last thing you want a player doing. Keep them process-driven. Those hits will start falling for them.
Sansone with the sign, the pitch. Swing and a miss. Chase some high cheese running up and away. And back-to-back strikeouts for the Fairfield Southpaw here in the second inning. 3-0 Stags lead. 2 up, 2 down. Here's Tyler Simon out of the 6-hole. Simon has reached base in 5 straight. Carries a .312 average this season. 5 for 16 with 3 driven in. Lefty on righty here. Wind the pitch. Swing and a line drive sent into right field. A diving grab in right field made by Zaffino. And a heck of a play for Fairfield. Came running in towards the gap in right center. Extended towards us here in the press box. Takes the stab. He tumbles, loses the cap. And a great play for Fairfield. Retires the side in order here in the second inning. Nothing across for Kennesaw State. We've played 2. On to the third we go. Fairfield 3, Kennesaw State nothing. This is the KSU Owl Network.
Come on, guys. Hey, Blue.
Here we go to begin the third inning from sunny Stillwell Stadium. 3-0 Fairfield over Kennesaw State in the first ever meeting between the Stags and the Owls. Fairfield out of the MAC Conference, preseason number 2, behind the Monmouth Hawks. Fairfield last year started the year 28-0, ranked in Baseball America's top 25, fell to Ryder in the MAC Championship in the tournament, and got the conference's first ever at-large berth out to Austin, Texas. Mike Caruso up from the cleanup spot up against Myers to start the third inning. Caruso with a single in the first. Starts here with a 1-0 count. Kicking the pitch. Swinging a chopper back at the middle. Simon at short. Takes it around the right shoulder. A quick flip. A sling over to first. And he's put away 6-3. So for the first time so far, Trey, Myers is able to retire the leadoff batter.
Got the leadoff batter there. That's always a good start. And if you're the Owls, you're not panicking here. That's one of the mottos of this club, something Coach Coe talked about on the call this week. They're not going to panic. They're going to keep coming. They've been in this situation already this year. Let's see how they respond this time.
Venuto, a lefty, sends on the ground to Simon again. Near the left shin, he picks, throws to first, and beats him out by a few steps. Another 6-3 putout. Two up, two down for Myers in the third against Fairfield.
And this is just what you need. Right here, if you're Myers, you want a quick inning. You've had two long ones to start the game. A quick inning here, you can start that tide turning back in your team's favor.
Three pitches here in the third inning, 34 on the day. Zaffino up from the right side. He swings away and pops it foul over the press box, 0-1. Zaffino had that great grab in right field to close out the Owls half of the second inning. Stands at the dish, 0-1. Wind, 0-1 offering from the righty. Pops the zone, 0-2. Myers peers over the black glove and then time called by Zaffino at home plate. Briefly pops out, then back in. Doggles the black stick near the hip, holds it over the right shoulder. 0-2 as Myers tries to put him away. Called strike three, punches him out on the back door. A nice display of Myers mixing it around. Heater puts him down, and for the first time today, the Stags go down in order. Bottom three coming up at Stillwell Stadium with the score of Fairfield 3, Kennesaw State 0. This is the KSU Owl Network.
KSUOwls.com/tickets. Also, visit university stores for all your spirit wear, textbooks, and technology needs at www.bookstore.kennesaw.edu.
Back at the home half of the third inning from Stillwell Stadium, Fairfield 3, Kennesaw State 0. Nolan Alexander joined by Trey Fowler. Sansone, 6 up, 6 down against the Owls attack. He gets 7, 8, 9 here, starting out with Nick Kalina. right field or up from the left side. Sansone picked up a couple of strikeouts in the second. Hands over his head, wind in the pitch, and that nearly hits Kalina. Brushes him away near the black batting gloves as he steps out from the left side, 1-0. And Trey, looking here in the third inning for Kennesaw State. Wait on the pitch, the 1-0. A fastball that connects in the outer half, 1-1. What's it for the Owls approach? Is it similar here? Have you seen anything different from Sansung where you think maybe the approach changes the third time seeing him?
I think you got to stick with the approach you came into the game with, because I think you're going to see more of those fastballs in second time.
1-1. Call it a strike in the basement of the zone, 1-2.
You'll see more of those fastballs in probably the second time through the order. He has used the changeup more early in the count to the right-handed hitters, and he's given me some bad flashbacks.
1-2 pitch. Kalina stays alive, fouling that back to the net, reaching out for it.
Of Trevor DeLay from Liberty a year ago, he's getting some of the ride up and in on these left-handed hitters and tying up a little bit, just like Trevor did a year ago. A-Sun Conference Pitcher of the Year reminds me a lot of him out there on the mound.
1-2, two strikes against the leadoff batter of the third inning for KSU. The pitch. Nice side by Kalina as that one dives off the plate. Lower half of the zone, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Here against Kalina. Lefty on lefty and the offering. Swing and a fly ball out to shallow left center field. Three stags are there, and it lands for a base hit. Kalina on his way to second base. The throw to second bounces away from the second baseman, Bichetti. And Kalina's aboard for the Owls with a double in the first hit of the day for KSU.
Much like the Stags, put the ball in play with two strikes, see what happens. Great job by Kalina hustling out of the box there. Doesn't just settle for the single, gets to second base. Now he's in scoring position with nobody out.
Goes down to the box score for Kennesaw State as a deep line drive double off the wall. Here's Donovan Cash, the DH, up from the right side. Sansone moves into the stretch for the first time today. A peek at second, now to the plate, swinging a chopper out towards third, past the third baseman. Into left field, Kalina takes third base, and the Owls are on the corners with back-to-back base hits in the third.
Another one of those first-pitch changeups there early to the right-handed hitter. Cash didn't hit it hard, but he hit it in just the right spot. The Owls are in business here. Runners at first and third for Hudson Mims.
Pagliarini, the third baseman, backing up high hop underneath his glove. Hudson Mims, the second baseman, now up to the right side. He's reached base in three straight games. KSU, the runners in the corners, down 3-0 here in the third inning at home. Lefty on righty. Sansone kicks and deals and misses near the Black Owls lettering on the white pinstripes, 1-0. Berg-Evan holds on the runner at first. Sansone looks that way. Now to the plate. Swing and a miss. That one well outside the zone. Mims went fishing for it, 1-1. Mims a 400 hitter, 2-for-5 on the young season with a double. As a 1-1 count, Sansone back over to first. No tag applied. Cash diving back in on all fours. Middle infield, double play depth. Pagliarini parallel to the bag at third. The pitch. Misses outside, 2-1.
Mims is going to need to stick with a good approach here. He swung at the 1-0 changeup way off the plate. He's behind in the count again here. Might come with a similar pitch.
Mims, the freshman out of Macon. 2-1. Swinging a fly ball to right field. Zaffino running towards the line, still in fair territory. Makes a snow cone catch. Kalina tags from third base. It's a sacrifice fly, and the Owls are on the board. 3-1 our score in the third.
That's a tremendous job there by Donovan Cash. Going back to first, routine fly ball. You got a good idea that that's going to be caught at the college level. Tags up, gets back into scoring position. That could be a big, big play in this game before all is said and done.
Keep our eye on that one as Josh Hatcher steps up. Sansone wants to make sure that if he did leave in time, that was the call as he throws back over to first. Berg Evan on the bag, and Cash is ruled safe by the first base umpire, Patrick Gentry. So runner at second here with one away. 3-1 KSU trails in the third. Sansone to the plate. Swing and a miss by Hatcher. As he misses away 0-1. Hatcher 0-1 with a pop-up to short.
That play right there by Cash, something you practice time and time again, over and over at the beginning of practices. It paid off right there.
Knees bent from the left side. Hatcher awaits the pitch. Check swing, called a strike by Elzy towards the outer edge, 0-2 on Josh Hatcher. Sansone looks back to the shortstop, Kelly. Diagnoses a couple of arm signals. Cash strolls off the midway station. Southpaw sets from the letters. The pitch. Misses up and away, 1-2. You mentioned it before, Sansone, excellent job last year for Fairfield. And then was a Cape Cod League All-Star, the first ever All-Star in the Cape League in Fairfield's history, went 3-0 in the regular season. Collegiate Baseball named him a preseason All-American to the second team. 1-2 the count. Couple of peeks back at second base, and then time called by Hatcher. As Sansone deals a soft toss back to the battery mate Caruso. Hatcher out of the leadoff spot. The pitch. Swinging a foul back to the net. Hatcher underneath it. Count remains 1-2.
Sansone just tried what a lot of old school coaches will teach. When a batter calls time and steps out, lob one in there, get him to see it. If he looks at it, come back with a fastball, see if you can sneak it by him and speed his eyes up a little bit.
1-2. Swing and a miss. Blew that one by him with a fastball, and there's two away.
Wouldn't be surprised if that's something Coach Currier teaches, he believes in. He's been around the game a long time, over 30 years as a head coach, previously at the University of Vermont, now at Fairfield since 2012, doing great things both places.
751 wins over his 33 years as a skipper. Cash Young up from the right side, takes the first pitch and pops it up. Out to right center field. Strollo, the center fielder, towards the gap, and it's the right fielder, Zaffino, leaning for it. Calling away, Strollo makes the catch and puts it into the Owls' third inning. Kennesaw State gets a run on the board off of two base hits, no errors, and Cash Young, or Donovan Cash, excuse me, stranded at third base. We played three here at the Shake with a score, Fairfield 3, Kennesaw State 1. This is the KSU Owl Network. Fourth inning here at Stillwell Stadium, and the first of three between Fairfield and Kennesaw State. Our score, Fairfield 3, Kennesaw State 1. Nolan Alexander, and here to give you the play-by-play for the next three innings, Trey Fowler.
Thank you, Nolan. 3-1 ball game here as we lead, start off the top of the fourth. Myers kicks and delivers. Line drive into center field. That's going to be a base hit. Strollo starts the inning with another base hit. Hatcher over, gets it in quickly. And the Stags continue their good work on the first pitch.
You're exactly right, Trey. They are swinging away on the first offering and more times than not making contact. Solid job by Hatcher there, sprinting over in the gap in right center. And Strollo is a center fielder, so he has speed. But Hatcher able to cut it off and limit him to just a leadoff single as opposed to stretching it out to two.
Brings up the first baseman, Matt Bergevin. Myers checks on Strollo, delivers. Foul tipped into the mitt. Be ahead 0-1. As we mentioned before, Strollo's got the one stolen base on the year for the Stags. Myers will look to keep him close. Stags trying to get that run right back. Sets at the belt. Gives him a couple of looks. And throws over. Sliding back in safely is Strollo. Myers takes the sign from the wristband. Fairfield, one of the few teams so far that are using traditional signs. 0-1 from Myers. Fastball up in the zone. 82 miles an hour on that one.
It's like watching a football team line up in the I formation right now, Trey.
The old school wing T. 1-1 count. And the delivery. Fastball inside. That one at 85 miles an hour. Top of the fourth. 3-1. Stags lead it. Came out swinging early and often, scoring one in the first on a sac fly and two more in the second before the Owls played it a run in the last half inning. Stags looking to get it right back here. 2-1 for Myers. Fastball again inside. Move the count to 3-1. That one popped out of Hassan's mitt, but not far enough for Strollo to advance.
So according to my tally, this is the first three-ball count of the day for Myers. Partly because, as you said, Fairfield swings away the first pitch more times than not.
Throw over to first. He's back in safely. I don't know if they've seen three pitches in that yet.
It's a team 7-14 of the dish today.
3-1 pitch. Good time to put somebody in motion. We'll see if Strollo's running here. Pitch from Myers. Fastball, that one just off the plate inside, and that'll be ball four. And Bergevin will head down to first base. That'll put runners at first and second for the nine-hole hitter, Evan Berta. Berta's a unique story. Started his Stag career as a pitcher last year, didn't get a chance to get any time on the mound, went out, played summer ball, hit over 360 in summer ball, comes back this year, is going to be an outfielder, going to hit, didn't get a whole lot of opportunities early, but to the due to the injury to handle, he's in the starting lineup. Myers checks the runner at second. Berta squares around, bunts this one just foul, and Cash Young will pick it up over on the by the third base dugout. And that'll make the count 0-1 here to Berta. A lot of times it happens that way. You go in, his story is very reminiscent to Charlie Blackman, who played at Young Harris, played in the big leagues with the Rockies, signed at Georgia Tech, went to Georgia Tech to pitch, didn't pitch his first year, went out to summer ball, led the Valley League in hitting. 0-1 pitch is outside. Goes out, leads the Valley League in hitting, comes back to Georgia Tech the next year, hits for him, gets drafted, and that's all she wrote in terms of his career. He's a big leaguer. And he's done a lot of great things as a big leaguer, but it all started when he picked up the bat and stopped pitching.
So speaking of Chuck Nasty, Trey, I got to see my first game at Coors Field this summer. Got to tell you about it after this pitch.
1-1 pitch to Berta.
And that's a bunt. Myers will field it. They go to third in the dirt. And they're going to say Simon was off the bag, and they're going to call him safe here at third base. So the Owls ran the wheel play there, in which the third baseman charges, shortstop breaks in front of the runner and beats him to third base. Myers does a great job fielding that one on one hop. The throw was in the dirt. Great pick by Simon to pick it, but I think that Aaron Sarch is going to have Simon off the bag, and that's what it looks like. A little bit of a conference there from Coach Coe. He got the result that he wanted. He got the answer that he wanted, and now he's back in the dugout, and the Stags have the bases loaded here with nobody out looking to extend this lead. That one will go down as a sack fielder's choice for Berta. First pitch. Outside, ball one. Colin Kelly up. He is 0-for-1 on the day. Had a sacrifice fly his last time up. He started the game with that ball down the left field line that Corbin couldn't quite corral. 1-0 count to Kelly. Bases loaded here. 3-1 lead for the Stags. 1-0 pitch. Change up. Fouled off at the plate. We'll even the count at 1-1.
And I'm curious if the case for Kennesaw State was that Simon got knocked off the bag. Looking at it, Trey, and our call right here versus getting the YouTube feed, there's about a 10-second delay in watching it again. Tough to tell. It was such a bang-bang play, but it almost seemed like the
case. To Kelly. Ground ball to short. Simon's got it. Flips to Mims. Over to first, and that's a 6-4-3 double play. The third of the day induced by Jack Myers, and that will play to run for the Stags. They'll extend their lead to 4-1. But that's a big-time pitch right there to get two outs on one pitch. Hopefully you can leave that runner at third and limit the damage here. If you're Myers, if you're Bachete, you are looking to get a two-out knock and extend this lead to 5-1. First pitch to him. Breaking ball right through there for a strike. 69 miles an hour. Bachete's got two hits on the day. Two singles. Myers sets the 0-1, another breaking ball. This one misses inside. So Strollo scores, puts Matt Bergevin at third base with two outs. Top of the fourth inning from Kennesaw. Beautiful day, not a cloud in the sky. 1-1 pitch from Myers. Change up, fouled off at the plate into the backstop. And Myers will quickly jump ahead, 1-2.
And going back to that double play, that's one of the things that is a benefit if you are a ground ball pitcher when you work yourself into a jam. You know you have comfortability trying to induce a ground ball. You've seen it a lot of times before. And as you said, third time that's happened today for Myers.
1-2 pitch from Myers. Fastball hit high and deep to right field. Back goes Kalina, reaching for the wall. He's got it at the wall, and that will end the inning. But not before the Stags pick up one and extend their lead to 4-1 here on the KSU Owl Network.
Star School of Nursing came together and created the Metro Atlanta EMS Academy. KSU takes this opportunity to thank Metro Atlanta Ambulance Service for their support of KSU Athletics, and we congratulate you on the EMS Academy's ongoing success.
And we are back here on the KSU Owl Network. I'm Trey Fowler, joined in the booth by Nolan Alexander. Owls coming up to bat here in the bottom of the fourth, trailing 4-1. And the first batter up will be the left fielder, Zach Corbin. Corbin fouled out to the catcher, his first at bat in the first inning. The wind and the pitch from Sansone. Change up, down and away.
So real quickly, Trey, just got to finish the thought on my first game at Coors Field, because just a typical Nolan Alexander moment.
1-0 pitch to Corbin. Fastball hit high and deep to left field. Left fielder going back to the track. It's going to bounce up against the wall, and Corbin around first and chugging to second with a leadoff double. Just what the doctor ordered there for the Owls. Leadoff, extra base hit, just like an inning ago as Nick Colina led off the inning with a double.
That looked like a home run cut, Trey. And if that wind's not blowing directly in from left field, I think Corbin stands a good shot of making this what would turn into a two-run deficit at 4-2. But that was a really good cut by Corbin. And now back-to-back innings, Trey. The Owls have led it off with a double.
That's their M.O. Keep fighting. Don't panic. Keep doing what you do. Be yourselves, and good things will happen. Nick Hassan steps in. First pitch to him. Chopped over to third. He'll hold the runner, cross to first for out number one. So not what you're looking for there if you're the Owls. You want to make sure that at worst you get a ball to the right side on the ground, maybe a deep fly ball. You want to advance Corbin there. Hassan swings at the first pitch, changeup, rolls over it to Pagliarini at third for out number one.
You're exactly right there, Trey. And silver lining, I think, may be that Corbin makes the heads-up play, not trying to run in front of that ground ball.
Braden Eatson steps in. First pitch to him is downstairs for a ball. You're always taught as the base runner at second base. At you to your left, you advance. If it's to your right, you got to see it through. Corbin did a great job there of seeing it through. One-oh pitch from Sansone. Breaking ball, swing and a miss. Had Eatson way out in front there.
And fold on that one as it came inside. Anyway, I feel terrible about my Coors story now, because every time I brought it up, there's been action right after, and it's been building up, and it's not that good of a story.
The 1-1 pitch from Sansone, another breaking ball, another wave on and miss, and he'll jump ahead 1-2.
I'll give you the Cliff Notes version now, because Edson's about to put this in play. Of course, Coors Field, right? Launching pad. Rockies, 9 innings. Lose to the Brewers, singles the entire game. Never saw an extra base hit.
Sansone checks Corbin at second a couple times. Kicks and delivers. Another breaking ball, swing and a miss. Strike three, and that'll be the second out of the inning for the Owls.
And not often you see a breaking ball in that location. In a lefty-on-lefty matchup, he really threw it up and away. And Edson was off balance, but seemed like that whole at bat.
Good job by Sansone, mixing pitches. He got Edson with a couple of elevated fastballs his first at bat, and he goes to the breaking ball there. That'll bring up the shortstop, Tyler Simon. Owls need a two-out knock. Sansone sets, checks the runner at second, checks Corbin again, lifts and delivers. That'll be a changeup outside for ball one. Owls trail here 4-1, bottom of the fourth inning. Still early in Kennesaw. Beautiful day, decent crowd here. 1-0 pitch to Simon. Fastball grounded over to third. Pagliarini has it across to first, and that will end the Owls' bottom of the fourth. We head to the fifth with the Stags still on top, 4-1 on the KSU Owl Network.
Partner of Kennesaw State Athletics.
And we are back on the KSU Owl Network. I'm Trey Fowler, joined in the booth by Nolan Alexander as we head to the top of the fifth inning. The Stags will have Pagliarini leading off, followed by Caruso and Venuto. Pagliarini had a sack fly in the first, put the Stags on top. First pitch to him here, changeup down in the zone, swing and a miss for strike one. Sack fly in the first, 4-6-3 double play in his next at bat. Hitting here for the third time in the fifth inning. 0-1 pitch, fastball down and away. Moves the count to 1-1. Stags enter the game 2-1 after taking 2 out of 3 at Elon a week ago. Owls enter 4-1. 1-1 pitch. Fastball over the inside corner for a strike. 1-2. Owls enter 4-1. Took 3 of 4 over from Moorhead in a midweek matchup. Defeated Georgia State. Big in-state win there. 1-2 pitch for Myers. Changeup, swing and a miss. Strike three. And that's what Myers is doing. When he's going well, he's getting swings and misses on that changeup. That's what he did a week ago in his first Kennesaw State start to the tune of 7 strikeouts. And that'll bring up team captain and catcher Mike Caruso. Coach Currier had a lot of good things to say about Caruso on the call this morning. Team captain, team leader, leads by example. First pitch to him, breaking ball inside, almost hit him there. And that'll move the count to 1-0. Next pitch to him, saws him off, ground ball over to third. Cash Young has it over to first, and that'll be out number 2 here in the top of the fifth inning. Caruso co-captain on this team with tomorrow's game 1 starter, Jack Novellio. And that'll bring up the designated hitter, Matt Venuto. Venuto 1-for-2 on the day. Singled in his first at bat. Grounded out to short in his second. First pitch to him. Chopped down the right field line and off the wall. Myers jumps ahead 0-1. This is where Myers ran into a little bit of trouble a week ago. So far, so good here. Changeup misses outside. Brings the count to 1-1.
Okay to throw those when nobody's on base, Trey.
Gives your guys in the dugout a chance to get a little exercise and run out there and grab that ball. 1-1 pitch. Fastball, ground ball in a hole between short and second. Diving stop by Mims. He will not be able to get to his feet to make the play. So nice stop by Mims there to keep that ball on the infield, but unable to make the play, and that'll go down as a single for Venuto. And it'll bring up the right fielder, Matt Zaffino.
And I think he makes that play if he's able to make the transition into his throwing hand, his right arm, and pop up on his feet. Wasn't going to be the easiest play, and that's why it goes down as a hit. But as you said, a really good job just being able to stop it in the outfield grass.
First pitch to Zaffino. Fastball up and in. Tied him up, but it'll be a ball. Move the count to 1-0. Zaffino, a transfer from Hamilton University, Hamilton College, got to play in 3 games in the COVID-shortened season in 2020 and did not get to play a year ago as their conference only allowed freshmen and sophomores to play. 1-0 pitch to him is a strike right through there, swing and a miss on a fastball.
It's like the reverse redshirt rule there, Trey.
Never heard of that, Coach. Currier told me that this morning. I was very shocked. They only played 12 games, but he did not get to play in any of them. Saved him some extra time for Fairfield. 1-1 pitch to him. Breaking ball, pop down the right field line. That one's going to bend out of play and into the Fairfield bullpen on top of the batting cages down the right field line.
beautiful day here at Kennesaw. Breeze is blowing, a little chilly, but not too bad. Short sleeve weather at the start of the game. Sleeves might be necessary now. Myers sets and delivers the 1-2. Breaking ball on the corner for strike three, and that will end the Stags, top of the fifth inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, one left. We head to the bottom of the fifth on the KSU Owl Network. Stags still on top, 4-1. And we are back on the KSU Owl Network. We're going to take a little time for this moment in Owls history. On this day, February 25th, 2007, the Owls knocked off Samford University by a final score of 14-12. The winning pitcher in relief that day was future Cincinnati Red Justin Edwards. And the big hit came when Jerome Woolley had a bases-clearing double in the eighth inning. That led to the 14-12 lead. That's today's moment in Owl history.
Unofficial start of the Hunter McKay Classic. Samford grad Hunter McKay, staffer here at Kennesaw State.
And leading off for the Owls in the bottom of the fifth will be right fielder Nick Kalina. Kalina doubled and scored the only Owls run to this point. He digs in the left-handed batter's box here against Sansone. First pitch to him, fastball outside for ball one. Sansone's done a nice job here through four innings, giving up the one run. Four strikeouts for him to this point. Kalina wiggles the bat, and breaking ball downstairs for ball two.
So KSU has begun each of the last two innings with a double. Can Kalina do it again?
For the trifecta here. 2-0 pitch to him. That one's up and in, just misses him. 3-0.
Yeah, some chin music there. Sansone said, I don't want you to get a double. I'll go ahead and put you on first base.
I think that was a breaking ball there. They just got away from him a little bit. Sansone, the full windup over the head. And delivers the 3-0 fastball right through there on the outside corner for strike one. For those of you joining us on YouTube, we appreciate you watching. 3-1 delivery from Sansone. Fastball popped up into center field. Strollo settles under it. He's got it for out number one. Kalina got just underneath that one. Popped it up sky high to center field. For those of you joining us on YouTube, Michael Sansone shares a common trait with over 90% of Hall of Fame pitchers. If you can tell us what that is, we'll give you a little credit. We'll give you a shout out here on the KSU Owl Network. Shares a common trait with over 90% of Hall of Fame pitchers. If you can tell us what it is, we'll give you a little shout out. First pitch to Cash is a fastball in the outside corner for strike one. And if none of our YouTube listeners or watchers can tell us, we'll let Mr. Nolan Alexander try to figure it out. 0-1 pitch to Cash. Change up outside. 1-1. Cash singled in his first at bat. Move Kalina to third before the Hudson Mims sacrifice fly. One ball, one strike, one out. The pitch, check swing, fouled it off to the backstop. And Sansone quickly jumps ahead of Cash, 1-2.
Well, Trey, I know something that he shares 100% in common with Hall of Fame pitchers.
What do you got?
It's a pitcher, too.
There you go. That's a good one.
It's your Yogi Berra comment for the day.
1-2 pitch. Fastball lined into right. And it'll be an easy play for Safino. And it'll be out number two for the Owls here in the fifth.
Want to welcome in some of our listeners here and watchers here on YouTube. Marcus, Dan, Lena, Joshua. I can't officially call you, you know, our first comment there.
That'll bring up Hudson Mims, the second baseman. Hudson Mims knocked in the Owls' first run with a sacrifice fly back in the third. First pitch is outside for a ball. Another change up there.
I'll just say the little M who started us off today.
Sansone with a little rock and delivers to Mims. Fastball right through there for a strike. 1-1 count. Two outs here in the bottom of the fifth. Owls trail the Stags 4-1. Stags came out swinging early. A lot of first pitch base hits to this point. Scored one in the first, two in the second, one in the fourth. Pitch to Mims is fouled over the press box and back out of play. And Sansone once again ahead today, 1-2. Been ahead of the count, heading the count a lot on these Owl hitters. Two pitch, change up, popped up. Another infield pop up. Let's see who takes this one. The second baseman, Bichetti, will take it, and that will end the inning for the Owls. 1-2-3 they go in the bottom of the fifth. We head to the sixth. Stags still on top, 4-1 on the KSU Owl Network. And we are back here on the KSU Owl Network. Top of the sixth inning coming from Kennesaw. Stags on top, 4-1. Myers still on the bump for the Owls. KSU ground crew is finishing up their great work, making sure the infield is ready to rock and roll. Due up here for the Stags in the sixth will be center fielder Ryan Strollo, first baseman Matt Bergevin, and the left fielder, Evan Berta. Strollo's 1-for-2 on the day, been on base twice, reached on an error, single. First pitch to him is a strike right through there. Changeup from Myers. Jumps on ahead in the count, 0-1. Owls have a little movement in their bullpen. It is all quiet in the Fairfield bullpen right now. Second pitch, another changeup, swing and a miss. Myers jumps ahead, 0-2. Strollo moved to center field with the injury to Mike Handel. 0-2 pitch to him. Outside there, moves the count to 1-2. Once again, we'd like to extend our well wishes and hopes and prayers for a speedy recovery to Mr. Handel. 1-2 pitch popped up into short center field. Out goes Simon. Out goes Mims. Simon will make the catch. Nice play there by Tyler Simon.
First baseman Matt Bergevin.
With one out, that'll bring up the first baseman, Matt Bergevin.
So I'm wearing my glasses today, so there's a little room for error here, but that looks to be number 44, Townsend, throwing for the Owls.
First pitch to Bergevin. Strike right through there. Fastball in the outside corner at 83 miles an hour. Bergevin, sophomore transfer from Concordia, Portland, who dropped the program and closed the school, was a basketball player and swimmer in high school, and shares something in common with head coach Bill Currier, who was the head coach of the University of Vermont when they dropped the program. So they can connect here. 0-1 pitch to him. Fastball up and away for a ball. Moves the count to 1-1. Myers kicks and delivers. Fastball fouled over by the Kennesaw State dugout. Sent some guys scrambling there. I think that was Spencer Hansen that ran out to pick that one up.
Trey, that's the first basketball swimmer combo I've heard in somebody's bio. Playing baseball.
1-2 pitch. Breaking ball. Fouled down the first baseline, and that one will reach the batting cages down the right field line. Basketball swimmer, good combination for a baseball player. You get athleticism from basketball. Baseball is a sport that requires athleticism, doesn't always breed it. So you get some athleticism from basketball. You get in great shape from swimming. 1-2 pitch. Breaking ball. He check swings, but he went around. Hassan will throw it down to first base for out number two. So another strikeout there for Myers. His fourth of the day.
That was a really nice way for you to throw baseball in there too, as far as athleticism goes.
That's something we talk about all the time as coaches. Two outs. First pitch to Berta. Strike right through there. Another changeup, 0-1 count. We talk about that a lot. Baseball requires athleticism, but it's the other sports many times kids play when they're younger that breeds it. 0-1 pitch, pop down the third base line. That one's going to bend in off the tarp and out of play. So, guys, that's why you see so many coaches go after two-sport athletes, football players that play baseball. Maybe a soccer guy that plays baseball because they know they're going to have the athleticism required to do this at an elite level. 0-2 pitch outside. Move the count to 1-2. Berta trying to turn over the lineup for the top of the order and Colin Kelly, who waits on deck. Wide open stance from Berta. Wiggles the bat. The pitch to him. Another foul ball down the left field line. This one's going to get all the way on to Kennesaw State University Drive. Take one bounce. And somebody will pick that up at their apartment this evening. 1-2. Change up, just missed, down and away. Even the count at 2-2 here. Berta steps in again, wide open stance, wiggles the bat over his head. Myers kicks and delivers. Change up, grounded to short. Simon's got it across the infield for out number three. So a 1-2-3, top of the sixth for the Stags. We'll head to the bottom half. Stags still on top, 4-1 on the KSU Owl Network.
Now.
We are back on the KSU Owls Network. I'm Trey Fowler, joined in the booth by Nolan Alexander. Owls trailing 4-1 here, but they'll have the top of the order due up here in the sixth, starting with the center fielder, Josh Hatcher. And for those of you waiting for the answer about what Mr. Sansone shares with 90% of Hall of Fame pitchers, I'll give that to you in just a minute. First pitch to Hatcher, swing and a miss on a fastball up. What I want you to do is, as Mr. Sansone delivers this next pitch, is watch his delivery.
I was going to say, am I going to feel stupid when I get this answer, Trey?
This point right here is what he shares with those Hall of Fame pitchers. 0-1 pitch to Hatchers, fouled off down the left field line. That one will reach the stands. Over 90% of Hall of Fame pitchers went with their hands over their head. Now, that's something, as more pitchers are getting inducted into the Hall of Fame, that did not do it here recently, but that was a big thing back in the day. You see a lot of guys do it, and you see a lot of guys that are on the cusp of being inducted that also do it this day and age. So there's a nice trivia question for you. You can stump some of your friends with. 0-2 pitch to Hatcher. Fastball inside. Knocks him off the plate a little bit, and that'll run the count to 1-2.
So, Trey, that begets the question, why does that seem to potentially be more effective?
There's actually been an article written about this, and I have my own theory, and we'll get to that after this 1-2
pitch. Sports science in the broadcast.
After this 1-2 pitch to Hatcher. Fastball lined into left center. On the run is Strollo. That one's going to get down. Hatcher's going to round first. He's going to head to second, and he will be in there with the third leadoff double of the day for the Owls. So a nice job right there by Hatcher. Two strikes, putting the ball in play, very similar to what Nick Colina did earlier in the third inning, and getting that double into left center field. The Owls need to put some runs on the board. Getting late in Kennesaw, and they've got the right part of the order to do it with, and Cash Young up. Cash Young came up on Wednesday night. Owls down 3-0. Hit a three-run home run to tie the game, a game the Owls would go on to win against Georgia State. Sansone sets, checks Hatcher, delivers the first pitch in the dirt. Hatcher reads it well, and he will be at third base with nobody out here in the bottom of the sixth.
You said it. Hatcher read that one well. He was intent. He was looking on. That's something that Co wants this team to have, the identity to be aggressive in all facets of the ball game, especially on the base paths. Be in tune with every single pitch. Hatcher was ready. He didn't waste a split second there, and does a good job getting over to third.
1-0 pitch coming to Young. Fastball up and in, and he pops it up on the infield. Ranging over is the first baseman. That one's going to fall just out of his reach. Take one hop off the concrete and bounce over the bleachers down the right field line. So very fortunate for Cash Young there. He'll get another life as the wind pushed that one just out of play. First baseman Matt Bergevin gave it a great look. Almost knocked down first base coach Bo Way in the process. 1-1 count to Young. Sansone sets and delivers. 1-1 pitch is popped up about in the same spot. This one a little bit deeper. Right fielder coming in, and Zaffino has it, and he'll hold Hatcher at third. So Cash Young unable to get it done there on the flyout for the first out of the inning to Matt Zaffino, the right fielder.
So lights have been turned on now as we're approaching sunset, but still having to deal with that sunlight. Zaffino, a good job of it over there in right field, shielding it away. That's probably the toughest part of the ballpark right now with the sun setting beyond third.
That'll bring up the left fielder, Zach Corbin, looking to drive this run in. First pitch to him is popped up in that same spot. Zaffino's going to come in again, shading his eyes. He's got it. This time Hatcher will tag, and he heads to the plate. The throw will be just up the line, and Hatcher will score. So that'll be a sacrifice fly for Zach Corbin. That'll be the second run for the day for the Owls, and they cut the Stags' lead to 2 at 4-2.
course, you'd love to see Corbin get a base knock there, but he sends it deep enough in right field. And we spoke about Kennesaw State being aggressive. Hatcher was ready for it. So a fine job there of Kennesaw State, at least getting a run on the board. You said it, Trey. The Owls need to start to string some runs together here.
So Sansone back in the windup. He'll take the hands over the head and deliver the first pitch to Hassan, a fastball that dots the outside corner at the bottom of the zone at 80 miles an hour. So to get back to my theory as to why that is so effective and why you see so many guys do that, it helps them keep their balance better. Their weight stays underneath them. And as a pitcher, you want to make sure you channel all your energy effectively and efficiently through the catcher. 0-1 pitch is right through there in the same spot, 0-2. And I think by going over the head, it allows you to stay balanced. It allows an easier transfer of energy. And then you can make sure that's all directed down and through your catcher, maximizes your command, maximizes your velocity, maximizes your secondary stuff. 0-2 pitch. This one's off the outside corner. The catcher Caruso, the captain, tried to walk that one off out there, but you're going to have a hard time getting that call on your opposing catcher from the home plate umpire. 1-2 count. 1-2, two outs here, bottom of the sixth. The Owls have scored one to cut the Fairfield lead to 4-2. The pitch to Hassan is rolled over to short. Kelly's got it across to first, and that will end the bottom of the sixth. But not before the Owls score one to cut into this Fairfield lead a little bit. At the end of six complete, the Stags are on top still, 4-2. We are back here on the KSU Owl Network, heading to the top of the seventh inning. I'm Trey Fowler, joined in the booth by Nolan Alexander, and I'm going to turn it over to him to take you the rest of the way on play-by-play.
Thank you so much, Trey. Great job yet again here in your first year broadcasting with us on the KSU Owl Network. Our score here in the top of the seventh, Fairfield 4, Kennesaw State 2. The Stags with a run in the first, 2 in the second, 1 more in the fourth. 4 runs, 8 hits, no errors, 5 left aboard. Kennesaw State with a stick in the third and the sixth inning. 2 runs, 4 hits, 2 errors, 2 stranded. And a new pitcher on the bump for the Owls, Mackenzie Stills, against the top of the lineup, Colin Kelly from the left side. Righty fires a wave and a miss as Stills pushes it past him. 0-1 the count. So to close the book on Myers in his second start in an Owl uniform after transferring as a graduate from Butler University, 6 innings, 0-1 pitch. That's ripped foul, left side, 0-2. 8 hits, 4 runs, 3 earned, 1 walk, 4 strikeout. 27 batters faced, 4 flyouts, 7 groundouts, 82 pitches, 59 in the zone. Lowers his ERA to 5.40. 0-2, swing and a chopper and a nice snag at the front edge of the Fairfield first base dugout. on the third stag closest to us. Count the same here on Kelly. And what's interesting, Trey, in Myers' previous start against Morehead State, appeared to be in control, had one inning, kind of got away from him at the end, gives up the same amount of earned runs. 0-2 pitch, called strike three, punches him out with a fastball in the back door, one away.
Nice pitch there by McKenzie Steeles. The last outing Myers had, he didn't get out of his last inning. He left two runners out there. Those runners ended up scoring. He deserved a little bit better fate in that last outing, deserved a better fate in this outing. A couple errors really cost the Owls defense early.
The pitch from Steeles misses low and away, 1-0 to Bichetti. 2-for-3 with a couple of singles. There were three innings in which Myers had the bases loaded, and he benefited from a double play in each of those frames. 1-0 the count here. Steeles kicks and fires. Swinging a chopper to third. Fielded on the left shoulder by Cash Young. Throws low to first. A bouncer. Edson cannot scoop it up. It trickles all the way to the warning track and foul ground. And Bichetti slides into second base.
It's a tough error right there. Got a chance to get two quick outs on the board. Kenzie Steeles coming in, throwing strikes. That fastball was at 89 miles an hour. A little bit different look than what Jack Myers was for these Stags hitters.
Pagliarini, the third baseman up. A sack fly, rolled into a double play in the second, and a strikeout in the fifth. 4-2 Fairfield, top of the seventh. The pitch waved and missed to the lefty batter, 0-1.
Kenzie Steeles throwing a couple of nice changeups here at the start of his outing. Not a pitch we've seen a ton of out of him so far in his Kennesaw State career, but has thrown a couple of really good ones. First pitch to Kelly, and first pitch there to Pagliarini.
0-1 the count, runner at second. The righty fires, swinging a foul to the backstop, 0-2. This the second appearance of the young season for Steeles. He pitched an inning and a third with three hits, three runs, all earned. No walks and a couple of strikeouts last weekend. 0-2 count here to Pagliarini. Sets below the letters and deals, and that's fouled off at the plate. So, Trey, we just talked about the great trivia question you had, and Sansone, hands over his head. Steeles stays out of the stretch. Yes, he has a runner at second, but a pitcher that likes to stay in the stretch. I'll ask you the question here after the 0-2 related to that. A peek back at second base, now to the plate. Swinging a ground ball sent to Edson at first on a hop near the knee. He takes it, five steps to the bag, and he beats out Pagliarini on a three unassisted. Bichetti takes third, two away. So what's the benefit of staying in the stretch now, Trey?
For McKenzie Steeles, it's actually something they've just figured out here over the last couple of weeks. He was throwing a bullpen a few weeks ago with Coach Passour, and they noticed that his metrics out of the stretch were actually better than out of the windup. So they've completely went away from the windup. They've scratched it, and he's getting better metrics, better reads, better velocity out of the stretch, more consistent.
Caruso up here, one hit on the day, a runner at third, two outs, and he looks inside, 1-0.
That's the power of having technology to be able to tell you the metrics. When you have that, you find out more about yourself, and it can be a very beneficial thing.
1-0 pitch from Steeles. That misses inside, 2-0. .59/.185 sophomore out of Fayetteville. Stands on the first base side of the rubbers. The shadows from the third base dugout creep up on the left side of the mound. Looking for a strike here, 2-0 pitch. Breaking ball misses off the plate, 3-0.
Kenzie Steeles was a part of that Vanderbilt program in 2019 that won the national championship. Transferred to Kennesaw after that year. And is still really young as a college pitcher. Has not logged a ton of innings to this point.
3-0. Fastball good, 3-1. 4-2 Fairfield our score. Top of the seventh. Runner at third, two outs for the Stags here in game one of three. And set to play a doubleheader tomorrow, with some weather expected on Sunday. The pitch. A fastball ripped foul. Look out. On the first base bleachers beyond the dugout. With a nice showing by Fairfield fans today, they danced out of the way. We have a dog in attendance as well. It's a golden retriever up there.
Beautiful dog. Coach Currier said that they would have a nice little following here in Atlanta with a lot of their alumni, and he is not disappointed with that statement.
And the pitch misses high near the hands, and they're on the corners with a two-out walk. See, that dog is well-behaved. My dog over there, there's a ball over there, can't hold on to him. Gone. Ripped the leash. Got to get it.
If my dogs were in attendance here, one would be sleeping, and she's a retriever just like that, and unfortunately has lost her hearing, and then the other one you would hear over us because he would bark at everything.
The pitch, big wave and a miss, Matt Venuto from the left side. He's looking to drive in three there. He's 2-for-3 today with a couple of singles. Stags on the corners, two outs, top of the seventh inning from Stillwell Stadium. Fairfield 4 and Kennesaw State 2. Stills in his first inning of relief of Jack Myers. Nods and fires. And the fastball misses down and in below the kneecaps, 1-1.
Venuto looking for a big hit here. Stags looking for him to get a big hit. Was named to the Austin Regional All-Tourney Team in 2021. Played in limited time towards the end of the year. Hit 373. They're looking for him to repeat that performance in this at-bat.
1-1 pitch. Fastball up and away as Hassan rises for it. Two balls and a strike. Wind blowing in from left field. Righty on lefty matchup. Stills delivers. Swinging a foul.
Another one of those good changeups right there by Mackenzie Stills. He's brought that pitch to the park today. And I would not be surprised to see him go to that one more time here.
And took a little off that one. Venuto was reaching for it, nearly falling to the back left knee. Slightly open stance from the left side. The 2-2 from Stills. Comes inside, runner heads to second base, and Elzy says that it hit him. Just grazing the right elbow. And the bases are loaded with two outs for Zaffino out of the six hole.
Zaffino's made some nice plays out there in right field today. He's been very, very busy. He's battled the sun. He's done what a lot of visiting right fielders have not been able to do at Stillwell Stadium in their first game. Fight the sun, make some big catches. Now he has an opportunity here with the bases loaded and two outs to come up with a big hit and translate some of that good vibes he has on defense into offense right here.
And for Fairfield, every runner on base has reached in a different way outside of a hit. Machete aboard with an E5, Caruso with a two-out walk, and then Venuto with a two-out hit by pitch. So a brief conference to the mound has broken up, and action will continue here. Bases loaded, two outs. 4-2, Fairfield leads Kennesaw State. Can Stills lead the seventh with a goose egg on the scoreboard? Stretch the pitch. Fastball outside, 1-0.
Fairfield trying to do exactly what they did in the top of the fourth. Owls scored their first run in the bottom of the third. Fairfield answered right back. Got the run back in the top of the fourth. Owls scored in the bottom of the sixth. Fairfield looking to do the same.
1-0. Misses away. 2-0.
And that's the mark of a good team. When you have a lead and the other team scores, you answer right back, get those runs back, and before you know it, you're at the end of the game and the other team just can't catch up.
The pitch. Misses down and in. 3-0. Zaffino. Sitting 0-for-3 today, a couple of strikeouts looking. Certainly Maggi has the take on here, trying to walk in a run with two outs. Can Stills find the zone. Delivers. And he does with a fastball in the outer half, 3-1. Take again or swing away?
I think you've got to be aggressive here if you're the Stags. I think you're ready to swing. You've got to be aggressive in the strike zone.
3-1, down and in. And and the Stags take a 5-2 lead on a bases-loaded walk. It's Bichetti who comes in to score as Zaffino picks up the RBI.
Bases-loaded walks plagued the Owls last Friday night as well, hoping to stop the bleeding here. These are the kind of innings that you need to see out of a guy like Mackenzie Steeles early in the year. Let him work through this. Let him fight his way through. Like I said, he's still young. Not a whole lot of innings logged in his college career.
Strollo to the plate. He scored twice today. And he takes a fastball for a strike, 0-1.
These are the type of outings early in the year that can be built upon for the end of the year.
0-1. Swing and a miss. Strollo mistimed that one. That was running up and away, 0-2. Bases loaded, two outs. Owls down by three here in the top of the seventh. Steeles looks to finish him off. The 0-2 called strike three. Landed in the attic. And Steeles ends the inning with the bases loaded. Picks up a couple of strikeouts. Does walk in an unearned run for Fairfield here in the seventh inning. It's one run off of no base hits, one error, and three stranded. Time to stretch at the shake. The score, Fairfield 5, Kennesaw State 2. On the KSU Owl Network. Hope you got time to stretch there. Bottom of the seventh inning from Stillwell Stadium. Fairfield 5, Kennesaw State 2. The Stags are running the first, two in the second. One more in the fourth and just added one on a bases-loaded walk in the seventh. Kennesaw State scratched one across in the third and sixth innings. Braden Edson steps in here out of the five hole. Sansone, the lefty, still on the bump. Well, just four hits today, the pitch. And that's good at the knees down the middle, 0-1. So far today for Fairfield's Friday starter, six innings, four hits, two earned runs, no walks, and four strikeouts. Wind, 0-1 offering. And that grazes the plate on the outer edge, 0-2. He's faced off against 22 batters, three extra base hits, all doubles, 11 flyouts, three groundouts. 73 pitches, 53 in the zone. Kick in the 0-2. And Edson looks outside. One ball, two strikes. Excuse me, a pinch hitter up here for Kennesaw State, Gavin Patel. So Patel in here for Edson. And the 1-2 above the letters, two balls and two strikes. Patel hitting .222 on the year. Got the opening day start at first base for Kennesaw State. A couple of ribbies on the season, 2-for-9. 2-2. Swing and a fly ball carrying to right field towards the gap. Zaffino drifting over and has the squeeze, one away.
Sansone has been very, very impressive today, and as advertised, not a lot of hard hit balls at all by the Owls today. Even the base hits have been balls that have just found holes, just dropped in the outfield. He's been in full command out there, much as we expected from the Cape All-Star and the preseason All-American.
Simon Ize's first base hit, sitting 0 for 2. Wind the pitch. Connects on the outer edge, 0-1. 5-2, Fairfield leads Kennesaw State, home half of the seventh from Stillwell Stadium. Southpaw grabs the sign. The battery mate Caruso hands over the head, the pitch. Swing and a foul ball carrying in the air and out of play towards Frey Road and Chastain. Over the right field side, and Simon down here at 0-2. Shadows are slowly engulfing most of the infield from left to right. Second baseman Bichetti stuck square in sunlight's way. 0-2 pitch. Swing and a foul straight back to us as it ricochets off the netting. Colina in the on-deck circle there to pick it up and hand it to Elzy. Simon tries to extend a five-game reach base streak. 0-2. And looks high at the letters in the outer half of the zone. One ball, two strikes.
Good start to the year for Simon. He made some adjustments to his swing and his stance from a year ago. Those have paid dividends to this point. He feels a lot more comfortable at the plate. And for a hitter, if you feel comfortable, you're in a good spot.
1-2 pitch, down and away, 2-2. Battle continues, lefty on righty. Bags empty, one out. The offering. Swing, a fly ball out to right center field. Zaffino drifting over against the sunlight. Another catch, two away on back-to-back F9s by the Owl lineup. So now it's Kennesaw State's right fielder, Nick Colina, 1-for-2 with a third inning double. Fairfield 5, KSU 2, bottom 7. Colina hangs the batter with the left shoulder, now rises. Southpaw on the mound, wind the pitch. And Colina takes a strike in the lower half of the zone, 0-1. Colina's dirtied up the pinstripes. Strong brush of dirt in the back of his thigh on the left leg and then the front left shin. Here comes the 0-1. Swing, a pop-up, third base side. Pagliarini in foul ground, runs over against the tarp, crashes into the tarp, and the ball comes out. He's back up standing, but went full speed ahead, and that tarp took a dive, and the ball squirted out.
That play is kind of the embodiment of this Fairfield team. Going hard, not taking anything off. Nice effort there by Pagliarini. A little bit of activity beginning in the Fairfield bullpen, the first of the day, as Sassone has been in total control.
0-2 the count. The pitch. And that's high at the shoulders.
After watching him through nearly seven innings here, he looks like the type of left-handed pitcher that left-handed hitters might actually do better against than right-handed hitters. Much like Tom Glavin was.
1-2 just misses near the knees. That one looked inside. Fairfield somewhat started to walk it off to the first base dugout. Deuces wild here. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Base is clear. 5-2 Fairfield leads in the seventh. Sansone the starter. Winds and delivers. Swing and a line drive, shot up the chute and into center field for a base knock, a one-hopper, the glove of Strollo.
Galena does a nice job there, not trying to do too much, taking what Sansone gives him right back through the middle. Let's see if that's the spark that the Owls need to get a two-out rally going here.
Galena with a two-for-three day, a double and a single. Donovan Casham, the pitch, and he dribbles that one foul to the Stags on-deck circle. Ricochets up the first baseline. Berg having to pick it up and roll it over to the Owls' third base dugout. 0-1 here on Cash, 1-for-2 with a third inning single. Runner at first, two outs as Kalina crawls off the bag. Owls down 5-2 in the seventh. Sansone moves back to the stretch. From the letters, kicks and delivers. Off speed, up and away, 1-1. Grips the ball just in front of his left knee. With bit knees, now comes set. And to the plate he goes. Swing and a miss. Down near the shoot tops, Cash over top of that one and down to his last strike here in the at-bat at 1-2. The pitch from Sansone. That's high at the helmet. 2-2. Ninety pitches now for Mike Sansone, a Cape League All-Star, preseason All-American. Here comes the 2-2. Upstairs. And Trey, correct me if I'm wrong, but this is the first full count of the day for Sansone.
You are correct. The activity in the Fairfield bullpen's number 30, Jack Urbeck.
So with Kalina at first, here comes an action pitch. Fairfield leads at 5-2 in the seventh with two outs. Runner at first. And here it comes, the pitch. It's Chopper sent back at the middle. Fielded at second base. The throw to first, a little bit wide by Bichetti, but Burke Evans stretches to his left. And Cash retired 4-3. Two-out single by Kalina. That's it for the Owls. No runs, a hit, no errors. One stranded. On to the eighth we go at the shake. Fairfield 5, Kennesaw State 2. This is the KSU Owl Network. Pick you back up in the top of the eighth inning. Fairfield 5, Kennesaw State 2 in the first of three in the first ever series between the Owls and the Stags. Nolan Alexander with Trey Fowler. With you today. I'd like to thank our production crew for bringing you this broadcast here in the KSU Owl Network. Mackenzie Stills in for a second inning of action, relieving Jack Myers. Righty looks on and delivers here, missing the zone.
K Coach Coe and the staff sending McKenzie back out there, wanting him to ride those good feels he had with that strikeout to end inning ago.
Bergevin out of the 8-hole, the pitch. Misses belt high, maybe a little bit outside, 2-0. Gavin Patel, who came in to begin the previous half inning as a pinch hitter for Braden Edson, stays in to play first base for Kennesaw State. So 2-0 the count here. Stills delivers. Fastball looked good. Not quite sure where that one missed. 3-0. Trey, I see you with the binoculars out looking at the KSU bullpen. Are we able to get a number?
We've got Ford Townsend and Ty Butler. Ford Townsend a righty, Ty Butler a lefty, both warming up in the owl pen.
And Kevin Elzey takes out his notebook. The home plate umpire steps just outside the right-handed batter's box. Do we get a warning there?
Not sure. I had my binoculars going there, so I'm not sure what happened right there.
And there's a strike, 3-1. We'll take a look at our A-Sun Conference scoreboard and more here in the eighth inning. 5-2 our score here. Fairfield leads. 3-1 pitch. And that's at the hands. Stills issues his third walk. And leadoff man aboard here for the 9-hole hitter, Berta.
Scores from around the league. Liberty leads Winthrop in the bottom of the fifth, 6-1. North Alabama has a 3-0 lead on Cincinnati. That game's in the top of the sixth.
The pitch. Lefty shows bunt, pulls it back as the fastball runs inside. Hassan looks to first, no throw.
One of the newest A-Sun members, Eastern Kentucky, won their game today against Ohio University by a final score of 4-3. Another new member, Central Arkansas, and Southern Illinois will play later.
Shows bunt again, called a strike as he doesn't connect, 1-1.
Jacksonville and Troy are also set to play later this evening. North Florida and Connecticut also will play at 6 p.m. Stetson and Columbia just underway. No score there in the top of the first.
Bunt shown, 1-1, tap towards the third base side. Picked up by Cash, throws to first, and runner advances to second base. The putout goes 5-3, one away. Bergevin now at the midway station.
Final two games from A-Sun action today will be Jacksonville State visiting Southern Miss at 7 p.m. and Florida Gulf Coast visiting Bethune-Cookman, also slated for a 7 p.m. first pitch. Nice play there by Cash Young on the sacrifice.
Lineup turns over for the Stags. Colin Kelly up today. Grounds this one softly to the mound. Stills, fields, throws to first. And the Owls get the out with Gavin Patel there. Sliding inside foul ground, switching the footwork nicely. Soft little tapper to the mound, 1-3 on the fifth at bat of the day for Colin Kelly. So two out, runner stays at second base, 5-2 Fairfield leads, top of the eighth inning.
Used the aggressiveness against Kelly there, first pitch changeup, got him out in front off the end of the bat. And you said it correctly, great job of the footwork over at first by Patel.
Bichetti reached on an error last inning. Scored and the pitch runs away from Stills, 1-0. So early returns on the A-Sun and non-conference action, Trey, I think have to be pretty good. Liberty won the series at top 10 Florida, took 2 out of 3 against the Gators. Then in midweek action, Jacksonville beat Florida State. This pitch grounded hotly over to short. Simon off one knee, Fields collects, throws wide of the bag. Patel applies the tag and he's out. Threw it on the home plate side of first base. It drew Patel off, grabbed it, spun, tagged out Bichetti, and the inning is over. Leadoff walk won't come back to hurt McKenzie Stills. No runs, no hits, no errors, and one stranded. Bottom eight coming up at Stillwell Stadium. Fairfield leads this one still, 5-2 on the KSU Owl Network.
Specializing in the Metro Atlanta area and North Atlanta, they're dedicated to helping you with all reach out to Dave at 770-401-0252. Now pitching for the Stags is number 30, Jack Burbeck.
So a new pitcher on the mound for the Fairfield Stags as we begin the bottom of the eighth inning. As Fairfield turns to the junior right-hander, 6'3", 210 out of Skillman, New Jersey, and Hunt School of Princeton, Jack Urbeck. And he gets the bottom of the Owls order here and the pitch to Hudson Mims. Is in there for a strike, 0-1. So Sansone today in line for the victory. 7 innings, 5 hits, just 2 earned. No walks, 4 Ks, 1 wild pitch. 92 pitches, 64 in the zone, lowers his ERA to 3 flat. And the pitch to Mims has some sharp break, but is off the plate. 1-1. Urbeck makes his third appearance of the season. Has a 9 flat ERA. 1 earned and 1 inning. The pitch at the letters, 2-1.
Urbeck's fastball run between 86 and 88. His go-to pitch is that big downward 12-6 breaking ball, mixing a change to the left-handed hitters as well.
Stretching the pitch. That fastball rockets in the zone around the knees. 2-2 on Hudson Mims.
He started the Austin Regional Final game against the University of Texas a year ago, so he's been in a big spot in his Fairfield career.
The pitch. Swing and a fly ball carrying down the line and right, and that falls for a base hit. Mims with a big turnaround first base and then retreats to the bag as Zaffino picks it up near the chalk line, and the Owls have a leadoff hit here in the eighth.
It's a big hit by Mims to get on base for the top of the order to turn it over. Now you need your two transfers to step up in a big spot here. Josh Hatcher, transfer, Mississippi State University, national champ a year ago, and on deck, Cash Young.
So here is Hatcher, and the pitch just misses away. 1-0.
The Owls hitters need to be patient here. In that regional final start a year ago against the University of Texas, he walked 4 hitters in 1 inning. So patience is key.
Leadoff man aboard here with no outs in the eighth. The pitch. Hatcher swings and misses a big cut from the left side, 1-1. He doubled in his last at bat. He's 1-for-3 today with a run scored. Here comes the 1-1, and that's in the dirt, picked up by the catcher Caruso. Mims had hung off the bag somewhat in no man's land off first base, paused, and decided to retreat.
Good decision by the freshman there. You never want to make an out on the bases in this situation, trailing 3 late in the ballgame.
The pitch. Swinging a hot grounder to second base. Fielded, flipped over to short base, and it's behind Kelly. And he's called out at second base by the third base umpire. Aaron Schorch, and the Owl fans cannot believe it. And here comes Ryan Coe out of the third base dugout.
And Ryan Coe has every bit to be mad there. That was absolutely no way that ball was secured at second base. Even if it was, he was off the bag by the time that ball hit his glove. There was no catch made. And I think that Aaron Schorch just missed that one. And unfortunately, with no replay here in Kennesaw, I'm not sure if anything is going to be done to change that call. He can ask them to get together and ask for help, but I'm not sure how much that's going to do right here. Big, big call right there. Instead of first and second, nobody out, you're looking at first base with one out and only five outs remaining in this ball game.
And Coe is straddling the fair foul line up the third base side. He's in foul territory. Schorch stands just on the other side of it. I mean, this is Hatfield and McCoy up the third baseline right now.
In old school days, that was one that probably would have gotten the coach to storm out of the dugout and meet him all the way at second base. But now with the new rules, you've got to go to the line and wait there. They'll come talk to you. And that's exactly what happened. Now they'll confer here, and we'll see if anybody had a better angle on it. The first base umpire here, Patrick Gentry, is one who could bail him out here. He probably had a really good look at that to see if he had secured that ball. He probably had the best look at it because he was seeing it from an angle, whereas Aaron Schorch was looking at that dead on. And that was actually probably a little bit behind him. So the best view of this play is probably going to be from Patrick Gentry. We'll see if he gives any help on this and we get this overturned.
5-2 our score, Fairfield leading Kennesaw State in the home half of the eighth inning. For what it's worth, Mims is staying at second base. The ruling was initially that he was out at second base on a 4-6 putout. The throw from Bichetti, the second baseman, was behind Kelly, and it's now been ruled safe. Mims is safe at second base, two aboard with no outs for Kennesaw State.
And no objection there from the Fairfield dugout. They knew exactly what had happened. I think it was obvious to everyone in attendance that that ball had not been secured, and now the Owls are set up in great position. And Cash Young finds himself in the same spot he was in on Wednesday night when he delivered the game-tying home run against Georgia State.
5-2 the score. The pitch, a breaking ball low here to Cash Young. The tying run sitting 0-3 today, riding a three-game hitting streak in his first year with the program.
And if you're Cash Young, you know the breaking ball is his go-to pitch. You got to see that up in the zone.
Kick the 1-0, swing and a miss. 1-1, Young chasing down and away. Lights are on here at Stillwell Stadium. Most of the field covered up in shadows. Save shallow center field extending to the right center gap. Each of these teams lining up on the railing in their respective dugouts. Series opener here at Stillwell. Urbex 1-1, a breaking ball ripped through the right side into right field. Mims is held up at third base. It's a base knock for Cash Young to load the bags for Kennesaw State here with no outs in the eighth inning.
Said he needed to see that breaking ball up, and that's exactly what he did right there. He got that breaking ball up in the zone, shot it through the right side, and now the bases are loaded for Zach Corbin.
Bags full of outs here. And now we'll get a visit to the mound by Bill Currier in his 11th season with Fairfield. And you said it before, there was action in the Fairfield bullpen. It's a righty that's been throwing for the Stags.
That's going to be the closer. Nick Graybeck led the MAC in saves in 2019. And here he comes. Going to be looking to shut this one down. And there's the sign and signal to the pen. So he's going to be coming in this one. Closer led the MAC in saves in 2019. And he's going to be looking to get another one here. Already has two on the year. Had saved both their games at Elon last weekend.
And he's going to earn his money here coming in the eighth. Bases loaded. Nobody out. The Owls down by three.
We'll come back here on the KSU Owl Network. So as Trey told you, Fairfield calls on its closer, Nick Graybeck, here with the bases loaded, no outs in the bottom of the eighth inning. Fairfield 5, Kennesaw State 2. The Stags have led wire to wire so far in this one with 8 hits, 1 error, 9 stranded. Kennesaw State with its 2 runs off 7 hits, 3 errors, 3 left to board. Graybeck with 2 saves already in 3 and 2/3 innings, no walks and a couple of strikeouts. He has not allowed a hit this season. Zach Corbin, the three-hole hitter, stands up here with the bases chock full of outs. Mims at third, Hatcher at second, Young at first. The pitch. Swing and a ground ball sent to third. It's bobbled, and the throw over to first base is just in time. Corbin retired by a step from Pagliarini. However, that scores Hudson Mims and makes it a 5-3 ball game.
Nice job not panicking there by Pagliarini, picking the ball up, getting the out. Really good stuff right there from the third baseman. Here for Graybeck, you're going to see a three-pitch mix that you don't always see out of closers. Fastball, slurve, change. He'll use that change when he's behind in the count. Fastball's got a little arm side run on it.
Nick Hassan up from the right side, the pitch from Graybeck. And that misses low, 1-0. Hatcher at third, Young at second base.
Nick Hassan had the big hit last Friday night to put the Owls ahead. See if he can get another big one here again this Friday night.
Hitting 333 with runners in scoring position, and the pitch is a fastball that's off the dish, 2-0. Caruso, the catcher, sliding out to his right. Riding a 5-game hitting streak dating back to last year, 0-3 today. A strikeout looking in the second. A couple of ground balls to the left side of the infield in his last two ABs. Graybeck sets from just above the letters with the tan glove, the 2-0 pitch. Swinging to ground, ball that's through up the middle for a base knock. Picked up in center field by Strollo. The throw to the plate is late, and we're tied at 5. It rolls to the backstop. Hassan puts a pause on at second base. Josh Hatcher and Cash Young cross home plate. 5-5 our score. 3 runs across here in the eighth for KSU.
Great job right there by Nick Hassan, getting that big hit we talked about. A guy who had a hard time finding holes a year ago is coming up clutch time and time again so far in 2022, and a great job of base running to get in the scoring position now
and set this up for Gavin Patel.
Here is Patel for the right side. 5-5 our score. First time we've been tied since the start of this ball game. The pitch, a breaking ball down and away. 1-0. Patel enters as a pinch hitter last inning and flew out to right on a 2-2 count.
Patel doesn't have a ton of RBIs so far in his KSU career, but the ones he has had have been big ones. He's looking for another one here. He's been a big-time hitter in the clutch over his season and a little change in an Owl uniform.
Kick the 1-0. Down and away, smothered by Caruso. It rolls in front of Patel. 2-0 the count. So Urbeck responsible for the runs across. Two hits, three runs, two earned. No walks, no strikeouts against three batters, 12 pitches, seven strikes. ERA balloons to 27 flat. Hassan dances off second base. Here comes a throwback to second base. The tag, Hassan in safely. Right arm extended underneath the tag of the second baseman, Bichetti.
If you're watching this game on YouTube, you may have saw there the second baseman flashed the open hand, which gave the pitcher the signal to spin pick, and he did a really good job executing it right there.
2-0. And Patel throws up the hands and looks inside. Three balls, no strikes. And my goodness, Trey, how this game has completely flipped once the All-American Mike Sansone left the bump.
The error looms large, just like it did for Fairfield offensively. The Owls capitalize.
3-0. Way outside in a four-pitch walk to Gavin Patel. Puts runners at first and second base with a one away for Tyler Simon out of the six hole.
Tyler Simon found himself in a very similar situation right here at Stillwell Stadium a year ago against the University of Georgia. He hit a laser into the left center field gap for a triple, a game the Owls would go on to win and knock off the University of Georgia in 2021. Tyler Simon's looking to do the very same thing right here. Coach Coe conferencing with him right now, talking a little bit. Now, this is done not so much to talk strategy. He's trying to buy some time for Nathan Holler, who's getting loose in the bullpen. They just got him, sent him down. They just got him up. Nathan Holler saved the game last week, saved the game on Wednesday night against Georgia State. He's become the de facto closer right now with Jared Ryan out for a little bit, and they're trying to buy some time to get him loose in case they do take the lead right here.
Simon 0 for 3 today, a couple of flyouts to right. Runners at first and second, one out, tied at 5 in the eighth inning. Righty on righty, the pitch from Graybag, a fastball that grabs the outer half, 0-1. And Trey, you're exactly right. It was the eighth inning against UGA, tied up at 4. And Tyler Simon, with that triple that you said, a laser to left center, scored Alex Carballo. And that ended up being the game-winning run, made it 5-4, KSU won 6-4. Long stare down at second base, 0-1. Another fastball that hooks the outer half, 0-2. KSU scored three runs in the eighth inning also in that game at home against the Bulldogs. Graybeck from the letters, righty on righty, the pitch. Down and in.
So as we talked about early in this game and as Coach Coe talked about on the call, this team doesn't panic. This team continues to fight, and now they find themselves in great position to win this ball game.
Simon awaits the 1-2. Here it is. Swing and a high chopper left side of the infield. Kelly waits on it. Goes the short route to second base and succeeds with a force out of Patel. A close play there, 6-4. Simon safe over at first base with a fielder's choice, and they're on the corners with two away.
Now, you would obviously, if you're the Owls, you would have loved to hit there to put you on top, but the simple contact puts runners at first and third with two outs, brings up a lot of options here. Third baseman's playing really far back. Nick Kalina's a savvy player. He could look to
drag bunt down that third base line to bring in that go-ahead run.
5-5 our score here in the eighth. Kalina 2-for-3 today. The pitch. And he takes low and away 1-0.
You also have the situation if Kalina falls behind in the count, you could do something here first and third. You've got speed at first base. Hassan runs well for a catcher at third.
Righty on lefty, open stance for Kalina. Throw back over to first. Simon back in diving. And a late tag by Berg-Evan. 1-0 the count. You said it, Hassan over at third. He had a two-run single that tied the ball game earlier this inning. Simon aboard with the fielder's choice. Graybeck from the stretch. Here's the pitch. Simon goes. Pitches upstairs. Pump fake from Caruso. Has no throw. Simon taking his time trotting into second base. A 2-0 count for Kalina. Now two in scoring position.
Now will be interesting to see what Fairfield does here to see if they continue to pitch to Kalina, who has two hits on the day, or if they go for the right-on-right matchup with Donovan Cash waiting on deck.
He's 1-for-3 today with a single. That is Cash on deck. DHing today out of the 8 hole. 2-0. And he takes a strike 2-1. Graybeck took a little off that one, floated across the plate. Kalina taps the bat at home plate. White helmet, white pinstripe jerseys. Trying to be the game winner here. 2-1. Swing and a miss, late on that one. 2-2.
Nick versus Nick here. Who's going to win this battle?
Deuces wild. Two balls, two strikes, two outs, two in scoring position. 5-5 our score in the eighth. Fairfield and Kennesaw State. Alza pushed across three this frame to knot it up. And the 2-2. Called strike three. Kalina goes down looking on a fastball. And Graybeck battles back after being down 2-0. And strands runners at second and third base. Kennesaw State puts on its rally caps, and the Owls push across three runs here in the inning and knot the ball game at 5. We head to the ninth inning on the KSU Owl Network. So Kennesaw State brings on a new pitcher in a brand new ball game. Top of the ninth inning from Stillwell Stadium. The Owls and the Fairfield Stags all tied up at 5. And they turn it over to number 22, Nathan Holler, 6'165" sophomore out of Lake Barrington, Illinois. Here to relieve McKenzie Stills, third pitcher of the day for Kennesaw State. Pagliarini up in the dish. And the third baseman looks at a holler strike above the knees, 0-1.
86-mile-an-hour fastball right through there.
From the first base side of the rubber, sets the belt, kicks and fires, and slings it in, 0-2. Stills, two innings today, no hits, one unearned run, three walks, two strikeouts, one hit batter, 11 faced, four groundouts, 40 pitches, 22 strikes. 0-2 from Holler. Called a ball. Missed by a seam on the lower outer half, 1-2.
That's a really good outing for Mackenzie Stills, just what he needed. As we said, young in his college career, actually logging innings, really good outing for him tonight.
Holler's 1-2. In and out of the mid of Hassan and off the dish, 2-2. Jack Myers got his second start for Kennesaw State in his young Owl career, the graduate transfer out of Butler in his first year of the program. Six innings today, eight hits, four runs, two earned, one walk, and four strikeouts. 2-2 from Holler. Swing and a miss.
Myers did exactly what you want to see your Friday night guy do. Came out, Fairfield came out swinging right away, hitting lasers all over the yard. Didn't have his best stuff, but you want your Friday night guy to hang in there, compete, fight, give you a chance to win. He did exactly that, and that's a large reason why the Owls are tied at five here in the ninth inning.
Strikeout number eight for Nathan Holler this year. He's got three walks, 1-0 with one save and six innings of work and one hit. Caruso up the dish, and he takes in the basement, 1-0. Cleanup hitter for Fairfield today, a single in the first, couple of ground outs in the third and fifth inning respectively, and then a walk in the seventh. 1-0 pitch. Called a strike as it sweeps across the upper half of the zone and grazes the outer edge, 1-1. Late break on that offering from Holler, who deals from a unique arm slot. 1-1. Check swing. That's a strike all the way as the fastball pipes down the middle, 1-2.
Remind many Owls fans of the likes of James Connell and Justin McAlvin, the 1-2-headed monster from the 2014 Super Regional team.
The pitch. Swing and a miss. Pulls the string, back-to-back K's for Holler. Sets the Stags down in order to start the ninth inning.
Coach Co identified Nate on this week's call as someone they would need to step up in the absence of Jared Ryan this weekend and deliver some big innings. And he's one out away from giving them a chance to win it in the bottom half of the ninth.
Venuto, the DH, up, chops this one up the middle. Simon at short, ranging on, great scoop behind the back. Throw is in time. You can hear the Kennesaw State Owls dugout up the third base side on its feet the entirety of that ninth inning, and especially aft. Tyler Simon flashes the leather at short. 1-2-3 go the Stags. Kennesaw State will try to walk it off the ninth with Cash, Mims, and Hatcher. Bottom nine coming up. We're tied at five on the KSU Owl Network. Bottom of the ninth inning, Kennesaw State with three across in the bottom of the eighth. Nathan Holler comes in, three up, three downs, a couple of strikeouts, a great play at short. And here come the Owls trying to come back and win this one against Fairfield. Donovan Cash up against Graybeck, the closer, in for his second inning out of the pen. The pitch, swing and a miss as he takes Cash outside, 0-1. Cash 1-for-3, a single back in the third inning. A line out and a ground out since then. Oh-1 pitch. Fastball down and in. Ball and a strike, and Trey, you can hear that third base dugout riding on every pitch, no matter if it's KSU defensively or the Owls of the plate here.
The momentum has definitely swung to that Owl dugout after, for a long time, it was in that Fairfield dugout.
1-1, sprayed into right field, and a leadoff single for Kennesaw State. Donovan Cash aboard the second knock of the day. Hudson Mims out of the nine hole up here. And Ryan Coe in his first year as head coach for Kennesaw State. Now here to visit with Elzey. And looks like we'll see a pinch runner. Kennesaw State brings in Joseph Gossett, the junior out of Jasper, Georgia, and Pickens High School to pinch run for Donovan Cash. And Cash is just mobbed in the dugout. Hudson Mims up here. Gossett leads off first. He's held on. And Graybeck throws that way. No tag by Berg Evan. Okay, Trey. Do you think bunt here or let Mims swing away?
I think they're going to bunt him up. They're going to let their transfers have a shot at winning this ball game.
Again over to first base. And he's back in safely. That time Berg Evan had come trotting in for a second, ready to possibly field a bunt. Then turned back around, a close play over at first. Gossett leads off. Mims shows bunt. The pitch pushed up the first baseline and foul.
If you're Mims here, that's where you want the ball to go. You want to deaden it out in front of the plate or get it in that first baseman's hands. The third baseman's going to be charging down your throat. He's going to be looking to go to second base with it if he fields it cleanly. So you want to try and put that ball in the first baseman's hands, the less athletic of the two charging here.
0-1 pitch. Bunted back towards the mound. Graybeck fields at the belt, throws to first, and the sacrifice works. 1-4 is Gossett. The winning run takes second base.
And if you're the Owls, you got to like the spot you sit in. You're setting the table for your two transfers. Josh Hatcher gets the first crack at it. The 2021 national champion. He's got the first crack. If he doesn't get it done, you've got Georgia College and State University transfer Cash Young waiting on deck, who has been a man who's had a flair for the dramatic already in his KSU career.
Hatcher the dish, tied at five, bottom of the ninth, one out. Gossett at second base. The pitch from Graybeck. Breaking ball low, rolls up the first base side. Gossett takes third base.
Another great job of reading the ball in the dirt by Joey Gossett. That right there is a byproduct of his hard work day in and day out. And this moment was made from him. Now, if you're Fairfield, you really got to ask yourself, what do you want to do here? Do you want to pitch to these guys, or do you want to set up a double play?
Infield comes in. 1-0 the count on Hatcher. The pitch from the righty misses up and away. 2-0.
If you're Hatcher here, you've got to be really patient. You want to see a ball up in the zone. Get something elevated. You can drive to the outfield. Outfield's in, infield's in.
Hitters count here, 2-0 pitch. And that misses down and in, and it hits Hatcher. Hits him on the cleat.
Nothing.
And they're on the corners.
Nothing hurt there if you're Fairfield. Now you've got the double play set up. It'll be interesting to see if they go back into double play depth here. We're going to have a visit on the mound. Everybody's going to get a chance to talk about this. They're going to get a chance to get all on the same page about exactly how they're going to play this with runners at first and third and only one away.
So the Fairfield defense huddles up here with Jordan Tabakman in his third season as the pitching coach. 5-5 our score. Joseph Goss, the winning run over at third base. Josh Hatcher aboard the hit-by-pitch at first. Kennesaw State was down 1-0 in the first inning, 3-0 after two. Scored a run in the third. Fairfield punched back with a run in the fourth. Each team scored one in the middle innings. Owls in the sixth, Fairfield in the seventh. KSU trailed 5-2 going bottom eight when the Owls scored three runs. And now a chance here in the first ever meeting to take a win against Fairfield. Cash Young up at the dish, out of the two hole, singled his last time. Gossett at third, Hatcher at first, middle infield. A little bit of step in from double play depth. Runner held at first here with one out. Outfield in, the pitch. Swing it, a hard hit ground ball that's through for a base knock, and Kennesaw State rallies to walk it off in the ninth inning.
Great job there by Cash Young, not waiting around. I said he's got a flair for the dramatic. And Nolan, I think I called that he would have the walk-off hit before the inning started.
Cash Young with a game-winning RBI and a hot shot up the third baseline, scores Joseph Gossett, and the Owls spray the water bottles and huddle up in shallow center field. 6-5, Kennesaw State wins. I do need to let you in on something, the listener. Trey Fowler walked me through that, how this ninth inning would go almost perfectly. You called it the leadoff hit. You called a pinch runner. You called a bunt over by Mims. You missed on the pinch runner, but it was close. And you said Cash Young would have the game-winning hit. My friend, we're going to get lotto tickets here in a minute.
It was a great night to be a part of this game. It was another great comeback by these Owls. Early in the year, they are showing that this is a team that does have the key ingredient of fight. They do it time and time again. Like Coach Coase said on the call, they never panic. They didn't panic facing a Cape League All-Star on the mound, down three runs. They got into the bullpen. The best thing they saw all night was Sansone being removed from that game. As soon as they got him out of there, they went to work on that bullpen, and they walk it off. 6-5 winners here tonight at Stillwell Stadium.
Well, the fight continues for Kennesaw State. The Owls bring the fight tonight. They move to 5-1 of the season. Fairfield falls to 2-2. Nathan Holler gets the win today for Kennesaw State, while Nick Raybeck is saddled for the loss. For Fairfield, he falls to 0-1. And Holler for Kennesaw State. He came in with a couple of saves. Wasn't a save situation, but he moves to 1-0. So the Owls get the win today. For Fairfield, 5 runs, 8 hits, 1 error, 9 left aboard. Kennesaw State, 6 runs, 10 hits, 3 errors, 5 left on. Trey, you made this comment a couple times talking about the pitching for Kennesaw State. Overall, not the best day pitching. For Myers, hanging in there, getting the 3 double plays. And for Stills, yes, there was a run walked in, but he's able to work himself eventually out of that, limiting the damage. Kind of the story for KSU so far. At times when the pitching's not the best, limit it, don't give up a huge crooked number, and eventually the offense is going to catch up.
Well, that's the key. Don't give up the crooked number. And a lot of the adversity that the pitchers faced tonight was not of their own doing. They bounced back when their defense did not play very well for them. It was an error that scored off Mackenzie Steele's, 2 errors scored with Jack Myers on the mound, and it's a testament to a pitcher when he can keep his composure and limit the damage when his defense isn't doing what he is accustomed to them doing or expects them to do. This Kennesaw State team has been a very good defensive team so far early in the year. Little shaky tonight, but when one part of your team doesn't have the greatest night, the other parts have to pick it up. The pitching and offense definitely did that here this evening.
6-5, Kennesaw State wins. Holler gets the victory for the Owls while Graybeck suffers the loss. Tomorrow, a doubleheader, 9 innings and then 7. Trey Fowler will have the call for you here in the KSU Owl Network, I believe 12 p.m. first pitch. 12 p.m. first pitch, Kennesaw State and Fairfield. Big thanks to our production crew with us today. For Trey Fowler, I'm Nolan Alexander saying good night from Stillwell Stadium, where the Owls rally and walk it off 6-5 over Fairfield. We'll see you tomorrow. Until then, God bless.